Yongjing.
네, 안녕하십니까.
So good afternoon, everyone.
오늘은 제가 엔소프트가 시리어스 게임에 대해서 어떤
So NCSoft
아이디어를
2,
가지고
so
있는지에
what kind of
알려주세요.
ideas of serious
관련된
game
이야기입니다.
NCSoft has is my topic of my
전에 자기
presentation.
소개를 슬라이드를 만들었는데 앞에서
So
별로
I
하셔서
prepared my introduction.
제
The
이름은
slide was so Laurent already just introduced me.
96년 정도부터
So my name is
게임을
Kim
만들기
Hyungjin, Hyungjin
시작했습니다.
Kim. Then so I just started so designing game from 1996.
엔소프트의
I just joined NCSoft so in 1998, and then so I just served as a designer, lead designer of Lineage 1 and Lineage 2.
현재는 그 엔소프트에서
Currently, so I'm a creative director and then also the head of the design team.
제가 오늘 여러분들과 공유하고 싶은 얘기는
So the topic that I want to share with you is
전
about the CEO, Mr. Kim.
사람들을 모아놓고
so he just held a meeting so with the game design team. So I started with talks that we had with the CEO of NCSoft. So our CEO just asked us to just include the joy of learning in your design of game. So the joy of learning so could be the so very interesting topic that we have to think about. So whether it would be the designing of game or other so industry businesses. So I'm serving as the head of the designing team of a gaming company. So we are also working on so education-related gaming. So from the year before last year, So the production of gaming for education so has started so becoming a one major area of gaming of the game industry. So I'm one of those so who are making efforts to so produce education related games. In the past, only the educational organizations so had interest in so producing those educational games. So, but recently, the number of games that are related to education is increasing. So this has become the one of the main topics for the game industry. So I really like the idea and the current trend. However, so the point that is making me feel sad is
제가 직업상 그쪽 게임들을 많이 플레이를 해보는데
So, as a game designer, I'm playing with many education games. But most of them are not interesting at all. Only a few of them might be very interesting. But against the total number of education games, the number of games that are interesting is very small.
생각을 하게 되죠. 왜 재미가 없을까?
It reminds me of what makes these education games not interesting.
그러니까 이제 교육용 게임은 그러니까 뭐 교육용 게임이니까 당연한 얘기입니다만.
So educational games
두 가지 요소를 담게 돼 있어요.
Must have these two components. Learning
그러니까
and gameplay.
게임을 재밌게 만드는 어떤 핵심적인 그러니까 게임플레이
So these are the two major components of so the educational games.
슬라이드에 이 얘기가 계속 나와서 그러니까 학습에 해당하는 걸 이제 L로
so
하고 그러니까 이제 게임에 해당하는 게임
So often use these two words, learning and gameplay. So L, just L here, from here, so L stands for learning and G for gameplay. So please understand for that. Understand that.
어떤 교육 업체나 그런 쪽에 이제 분들
So I have had the chances to talk with the people from the educational industry and academic area. These are the
So thinking stuff, those people,
so usually learning is not considered as an interesting topic for most of the people. But games is just considered as a bit, so the thing of fun. So for the developers of educational games, so we have to understand the educational games, it's just the combining of the learning plus game. So to make the children be attracted to these educational games, so we have to make our the products more interesting to those children. So we are first to just expand the component of gaming of this educational games. This is just the one idea of game developers.
하셨던 것 같아요. 근데 이제 제 생각에는
But in my opinion,
그 교육용 게임을 만든다는 게
So when developing educational games,
게임적인 요소가 단순히 더해지는 게 아니라
It is not just the simple combination of learning and games.
곱해지는 거라고 생각합니다.
So my belief is that the learnings should be multiplied by another component, gaming. This is not just the physical combination. This is kind of the chemical combination, and this so in order to just make a synergy.
그러니까 이제 곱하기다 보니까 이제 게임이 재미있어도 그 러닝과 배움 이런 그 안에 있는 배움의 과정이 재미가 없으면.
So even though games are funny, if the learning component of those games are not quite meaningful, it means that they are not successful games.
지금까지 많은 교육용 게임들이 재미가 없었던 이유가 아닐까?
I believe this is one of the reasons why many education purpose games failed.
그러니 이제 자연스럽게 이제 제가 생각하는 교육용 게임이라는 것은
So the concept of educational games that I think of is that both game component and the learning component should be balanced in an entertaining way.
And
in order to achieve that purpose,
저희 사장님이 말씀하셨던 것과 같이
그러니까
배움의 즐거움이라는 것을 표현하기 위해서 그러니까 게임 플레이를
make efforts to express or deliver the joy of learning.
사실은 뭐 당연한
To that was the keyword that my boss gave to me to think about.
쉬운 얘기도 아니고요.
This is not an easy job, I know that.
하지만 그러니까 저희는 이것에 도전을 하여야
But I think in order to survive or in order to succeed in combining games with education, we should focus on searching for the joy of learning.
지금 만들고 있는 사실 저희가 이쪽 분야의 작업을 시작한 지 얼마 되지 않았습니다.
And C-Soft has just started its efforts to create or design games for educational purpose. And I'd like to introduce two examples or two projects that our company or my company works on. The first one is Magic Panja Online. Some of you may know this.
만들어진 그 교육용 만화 책입니다 원래.
This magic 한자 is a kind of a educational cartoon.
손오공이 한자 마법을 써서
to teach students Chinese characters.
담고 있는데 이게 통산 천만 부 이상 팔린.
So 손오공, the character called 손오공 is starting his journey to learn 한자. That is the main theme of the cartoon.
한자의 그 담긴 의미를 진정으로 이해를 하면 그 한자의 뜻을 가지고
If the game players understand the meaning of 한자 or Chinese characters, actually they can use some magic or they can use some weapons or items.
저희가 만들고 있는 이 게임에서 저희의 도전은 방금 말씀드렸죠.
The challenge is that we were my company faces
발음이 어떻게 되고
in developing this game is how we can check whether the users really understand the meaning and the origin of the Chinese characters.
만화를 보시는 보시지 않은 분을 위해서 예를 하나 들어보고.
I'll just take an example to help you understand better. This is a cartoon from. This is a.
적이 나타났다고 치죠.
Part that I just took from the cartoon. Just let's just imagine that you are playing this game.
일반적으로 게임에서 적이 나타나면, 그러니까 게임의 목표는 뭐냐면 적을 물리치는.
Let's say you just face an enemy, and the goal of the game is to defeat the enemy.
그러니까 한자의 뜻을 그리고 한자의 뜻 형태를.
Since this is an educational game, also the users or the players should learn 한자 or Chinese characters while playing the game.
이 만화에서 작을 소자. 를 외쳤던가 작을 작아져라 작을 소라고
The character
마법을 쓰면
or 소녀공 uses his magic and making his enemy
그래서 이제 원래
tiny creature
못 이길 대상이었는데 주인공이 충분히 이길 만한 대상이 돼서
so the giant enemy becomes defeatable.
그러니까 이 과정에서 중요한 건 그러니까 실제로 이것이 게임의 구현이 됐을 때 그러니까 아이가
So if this idea is implemented here, so here the Sono Gong, here does he just use the word the small, so which is translated into so in Chinese the language. So if just said so, then so the enemy just has become the smaller. So the Sono Gong so could defeat him. So This game just isn't a good example of the combination of learning plus gameplay. So let me take the second example. So we just call this a prototype as an English village. So as you might know, here the parents in Korea are just crazy about English education for their kids. So parents don't have enough money then, so they could send their kids to this English village at relatively reasonable price.
저희는 이제 MMORPG를 만들던 회사니까
So, NCSoft is the producer of MMORPG. So, through the cyber world, we created this English village that will allow kids to just experience the English conversation, the environment on English village created by NCSoft.
라는 생각을 한 거죠. 그런 생각만 했고 아직 된 건 별로 없었지만
This has not been implemented yet.
이제 예를 하나 들어보겠습니다.
So let me take an example.
그 어떤 애가
Here there's one kid. 그
이제 조기 유학을 가서 이제 미국
So he went to the US for the just English education. So now so this kid is in Central Park in New York. So this is kind of the MMORPG game.
여기서 이제 게임의 목표는
Here the objective of game.
먹어야 내가 이제 굶어 죽지 않아.
So this kid so has to have the lunch to defeat the enemy.
내가
Here the educational objective is to learn
일상 회화를 그러니까 체득하게 하는
So English conversation just practice English conversation.
이제 얘가 그 핫도그 장수 아저씨고 그러니까
So here the physical objective is to have just a meal. So here the kid, so he went to a kind of kiosk, so that is selling the hot dogs. So here the character of the student kid.
게임이 이제 음성 인식으로 진행이 됩니다. 그래서
So this game provides of the voice service of the main characters.
하면서
So when the user just plays the game, then so he could hear the voice of the characters.
그래서 이제 이런 스타일의 게임을 만들려고 생각을 하니
So when we had this just idea to develop this game. Then so we were thinking about how could you just implement the voice recognition technology into this game. So here the so main character, the student said to this vendor, I want to have a hot dog. So could you give me a hot dog? And then so here the vendor so just asks this kid, so do you want the onion or the other types of ingredients? So in the Korean environment, so our money just counting. The system is different from that of U.S. So kind of the sense, the concept of sense is not familiar to Korean users. So this game service is provided online. So the virtual world service is provided online. But we have to apply the just the unique environments of the specific market that we are targeting. So this is one of the ideas that we have regarding the development of this type of game, learning game. So we will allow the students and the children to experience the different the environment of different countries as well. So I just give you the kind of overview of the two projects that we are working on. So, but I have to emphasize that we always have the same objective, basic objectives. How we can make a balance between the learning and game play. This has been always our challenge and our objective as well. So how could you, so making our games more fun to users by just making balance between these two components. So the developers of the educational games, so always this kind of so just the objective is always a challenge. But I hope that so we could so realize our dream and objectives. So even for me, personally, I want to be a good user of this kind of game. So by using this kind of game, thank you.